What's up, guys? How's it going? Wow. I'm Scott Toria with the Immoral Thieves. Currently, we actually do have a war popping off at the moment, Immoral Thieves versus War Whales happening right now. I had to pop over after hearing the news about ByeForever getting a 9v10 triple. Not only that, but they also got a 9v11 double. Holy cow, it's insane. So they asked me to pop over, make a video of it, and then put it out for you guys to see. Much appreciated, ByeForever. Much love, I do appreciate that. So we're gonna go ahead and dive right in and show what happened here. So it looks like Steel Beast coming in on Bob Monel's base. Wow. To open it up with some trash cleanup with these archers. All right, flight begins immediately. The drop of the two hounds between the 12 all the way at the 3. Pushing those hastes in to take out those first two infernos at the same time. Down goes the rages. Interestingly enough, guys, the last time we've seen a 10v or 9v10 triple in the CWL invite was Joey from the Immoral Thieves running double rage, double heal, actually utilizing a different attack this time, absolutely crushing this base. No problem. Look at the amount of loons he has left. Gets the pop out of the hounds, clearing the last of the point there, as well as taking out that Wizzy with his Archer Queen. Gorgeous attack. Holy cow. Incredible work from ByeForever here. Plenty of pups. Great split from the loon too to kind of help out with the trash cleanup at the end. Both heroes still alive, still fighting. That's incredible. That is incredible. Gonna do a times two here. Wow, shout out to Steel Beast from ByeForever again. That right there is a huge achievement. Very well done, gorgeously executed, and absolutely smashed the base. And then of course we've got to show the 9v11 dubs too. All right, opens up with a couple minions. Obviously run more the anti-3 base here. So, I mean, it happens. I mean, this is kind of a result. Anytime a clan decides to run this type of base for their 11s, a lot of times you'll see it when they kind of expect their 10s to be cleared and the 11v11 attempts are going to pop off as a means to kind of keep it from happening, getting tripled via the 11v11. So, you know, as a result of that, you'll see something like this happening where the 9s can come out and, sorry about that, my iPad, can come out and get the double on it and, you know, taking that advantage, not having to burn a Town Hall 10 attack on this base in order to clear 11s and then go more for those 10v10 attempts. Well, clearing up another 10 from their 9, taking out one of those as well. So, wow, big Lou. I know, you know, a 9v11, whenever you're facing up against an anti-3, is, you know, almost to be expected at this point, but still, it's something you don't see too often, and I feel like I had to show it as well, so. Queen, just so much value to the charge here. Interestingly enough, didn't take the jump to kind of clear the core, but he utilizes those Valks for the garbage on the outside of the base to pick up that percent. And not only that, but picking up some great percent. Anytime you get that 60 plus, that's a cleared 11 at that point. So great work from ByeForever. Shout out to them and good luck for the rest of this war. I appreciate you guys, you know, taking a look at these attacks, and hey, expect a recap video after after the IT versus War Whales war as well. So have a good night, guys. Much love.